A very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Honorable Chief Justice of the Guwahati High Court, Honorable Mr. Justice Ajit Singh, Honorable Mr. Justice Ujjal, Judge Guwahati High Court, Vice Chancellor of National Law University and Judicial Academy, Assam, Professor Dr. J.S. Patil, Managing Director of IIRDDA, Dr. Ramani, Barman, Professor Dr. Shamnad, Basheer, Managing Trustee of IDIA, Charitable Trust, Mr. Vinod, Seshan, District Commissioner of Kamrup, all the other esteemed faculty members, visiting dignitaries, members of the faculty, and my friends from the student fraternity. We all are gathered here today to celebrate a very momentous occasion for our university. After the great example which the Center for Child Rights has set for the university by working towards raising awareness for child rights, the university has now established its next big center, which is the Center for Disability Studies and Health Laws. Through this center, the university aims to bring in a paradigm shift in which disability as well as health laws are looked upon in the country. The painting exhibition that you must have witnessed outside in the lobby area, all of them are masterpieces made by children who are specially abled. And let's make a solemn resolve today for this evening. We shall not call them the disabled or the differently abled. Let's just call them specially abled. I think the paintings are a testament to their abilities. So big round of applause for the painting that you see. Now that the center has been inaugurated by a chief guest for the evening, Honorable Mr. Justice Ajit Singh, I now like to request our Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. J.S. Patil, to please come and give the welcome to us.
Ladies and gentlemen, today is a very auspicious day in the annals of National Law University, Assam. Just now we have inaugurated a unique center called the Center for Disability Studies and Health Laws under the able leadership of our esteemed Chancellor of the University and Chief Justice of Guwahati High Court, Honorable Mr. Justice Ajit Singh. 21st century is an era of the marginalized. In the philosophy of deconstruction, all the notions and concepts that have been built in the last 300 years are getting challenged. And all those who have been suppressed, oppressed, not given their space in the civilizations, has been there for crime all these years. Now their voices are slowly being heard by the others, and others have started working for these people. But today the argument of the focused community has been, as our message goes, nothing about us without us. Nothing about us without us. So we, the specially able people, want to be on the center stage on our own as a mighty people with our own mighty rights. That is the kind of a new philosophy that is emerging in the postmodern world. It is challenging all the ethos established in the modern times. in tune with this new development that is obtaining world over, National Law University Assam, in its right earnest, has started working not only just philosophically but also experientially in building a center which will not only build research culture, law culture, but also a social, practical, reality, experiential type of a culture of taking along with us our this new focused community and give them their own pivotal role to play in establishing themselves as a distinguished community among ourselves. So on this occasion, I feel really blessed by the presence of such wonderful gathering of the great eminent people over here. We have our Honorable Chief Justice, Justice Ajit Singh. He has been kind enough to come all the way and inaugurate this center. With his kind blessings, I am sure we will go a long way in building up that kind of an equalitarian society which we have been talking about in the last 300 years. It has been only a figure of a speech. And a National Law University Assam will be in the center stage in building this with the kind blessings of Honorable Justice Ajit Singh Ji. Sir, on this occasion, I extend a very warm welcome to you. This very small function, but yet a very unique and important function. I also extend my hearty welcome to Honorable Justice Ujjal, who has been a very great supporter of National Law University Assam in many ways. I welcome the director of IIT for his kind presence, and I will be missing a lot if I do not welcome Dr. Ramani, Managing Director of IIRDDA, who is a great noble soul of working singularly in establishing his own institution and then building up some big thing. And I look forward, sir, for your kind cooperation in building our own center over here, and we would like to, would want to work with you. I also welcome Dr. Shamnad, Basheer of IDIA, whom we have invited to participate in this. I will be right now signing a memorandum of understanding between our two organizations to incorporate ourselves in this new agenda of realizing our dreams of building something good in this center. I welcome all other, our Deputy Commissioner and other distinguished officers, our Registrar General, our judicial officers, and all the faculty and my distinguished scholars from Intellectual Property Rights National Workshop, Professor Pai, Professor P. Ramakrishna, and the others who have come over here, the distinguished delegates, all of you, a very warm welcome, and thank you very much for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Welcome you again. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your welcome address. As your host for this evening, I think it is also my duty that I apologize for the slight delay that you had in the program. So please accept the most sincerest of apologies. Moving on, we would now like to felicitate the dignitaries for this evening. I would now like to request Mr. Vinod Jamatia and Ms. Devakriti Sharma to please felicitate Honorable Mr. Justice Ajit Singh, Chief Justice of the Guwahati High Court. I would now like to request Ms. Shri Talukdar and Mr. Aman Kumar to please felicitate Honorable Mr. Justice Ujjal, Judge of the Guwahati High Court, with a traditional gamsa and a bouquet of flowers. I now like to request Mr. Vinod Jamatia and Ms. Devakriti Sharma to please felicitate Mr. Vinod Seshan, Deputy Commissioner, Kamrup.
I would now like to request Mr. Amar Kumar and Shri Talukdar to please felicitate Dr. Ramani Barman, Managing Director of IIRDDA. Mr. Vinod Jamatia and Ms. Devapriti Sharma to please felicitate Professor Dr. Shamnad, Basheer, Managing Trustee of IDIA Charitable Trust. Mr. Raman Kumar and Ms. Shri Talukdar to please felicitate the Director of IIT Guwahati. Mr. Vinod Jamatia and Ms. Devapriti Sharma to please felicitate our Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. J.S. Patil. For the evening, I now like to request Mr. Raman Kumar and Ms. Devapriti Sharma to please felicitate our honorable registrar. Mr. Sachin Sharma, Assistant Professor of Law, who is also the Center Coordinator for this new center, to deliver his inaugural address. Thank you.
So firstly, my apologies for this last moment as well. But we are doing for the first time in the center. Today is an important day in the saga of NLU Assam, as today another limb is going to be attached to our university. The Center for Disability Studies and Health Laws is a platform for right and act-based deliberations. So it is solely based on the mantra of nothing about us without us. But it simply highlights the proposition that in any deliberation on policy making for persons with disability, we need their active participation. But if we contextualize this proposition in Indian regard, the situation is unfortunate. Here we have our laws, our system, but without giving any considerations to persons with disability in their deliberation or their opinion or our local laws here. So that thing is something most important that we need to take care of. Because here, I believe our own concern is all about the nomenclature or the terminology used for persons with disability. And we are just justifying that whether the word Viklanga or Divyanga is appropriate. But we are not concerned about the basic rights, basic requirement which facilitates or guarantees the autonomy and dignified life to persons with disability. So people have very casual attitude. Now this is what my own experience as well as different studies shows, that a very casual opinion about persons with disabilities. Like if I take my own example, prior to establishment of this center at our university and particular to this particular program, we were not least bothered about arranging this ramp. So just 3-4 days when we are arranging this ramp for persons with disabilities, that it should be that accessible, that it should be free for any kind of barriers. So that is what, this is the attitude we need to somehow fight with. And that is why one famous scholar in disability jurisprudence, when he talks that it is a social impediment, social problem, rather than a medical problem. So we need to change the social mindset, the societal mindset. Only then there are possibilities that we are able to create a right place, right kind of dialogue in our country. So, and at center, this is our attempt to bridge the gap between the policy making and ground realities. So at center, if I move on with our basic objectives, so it will serve as a launch pad for participatory democracy in disability-oriented discourses, and to conduct various awareness programs on issues related to disability, sensitization, and activism, in getting association with various NGOs, various governmental, social welfare and healthcare departments to develop and facilitate literature on disability jurisprudence through engaging different corner of research, and which is somehow very lacking. So all literature available on disability is by someone else. So we need our own literature at first hand, and to start deliberating, start interacting with people. And one of the another objective of our center is to start certain courses, diploma courses, certificate courses, to start the right discourse or to build the right environment, disability friendly environment in our country. So the objective of what is somehow possible if you get in association with various local institutions working in the area, and IIRDDA is one of them, and which is working, as I know, very closely at the grassroots level. So very soon, sir, we are going to have an MOU with you. And similarly, IDIA, Professor Basheer is with us here, so it's working massively around accessibility issues. So that itself is most important factor or thing which is required for us. But at the same time, we need to think about the possible hurdles or challenges. So first, which I can think of is the financial assistance. So as a new institute or as a new center, we need that first-hand initial financial support. So on behalf of Professor Ujjal, the social justice head for our center, I request Honorable Chief Justice Ajit Singh sir to kindly help us in building this project. As I know, Lordship is deeply concerned with disability and empowerment issues, as sir has initiated a huge project in the entire state of Assam, which somehow deals with the empowering person with disability to creating the accessible, friendly environment or society. And that the program, one of them, we are lucky enough that one of its part is right now going on in our own campus on first floor. We are provided, this is under DCSA's observation when the program is going on. So we need such kind of programs, we need such kind of participation from society at large. So that is where I will personally believe which is required. And I know that our dream and objective is tough, it is hard to achieve, but I am confident enough that the kind of team which we have at our center, that soon we are able to make a dent into the reality, which is somewhere very much required. And now I would like to quote here Kabir, so who once said that dheere dheere re mana, dheere dheere sab kuch hoye, mali sinche sau ghada, ritu aaye phal hoye. So for us, we are like Mali, through our own efforts, we are trying to create that right kind of discourse, right kind of requirement or attitude. And I believe Ritu is the changing social or societal attitude. So until and unless we don't change that our own perception towards persons with disability, I don't think things are gonna change. So instead of engaging in our politics around language, whether it is a Divyanga, or disabled or handicapped, more important is to talk about or think about the apt perspective. Now we need to provide that scope for persons with disability where they can act. And this is the one basic motto with which our center is going to work. So nothing about us without us. So with these words, I would like to thank all Honorable Chief Justice Sir, Justice Bhuyan Sir,
Thank you, Seshan sir, for your inspiring inaugural address. I think when I started off with the evening, I said that we need to bring in a paradigm shift, and this is what the center is going to do. National Law University, Assam, is one of the most disabled-friendly campuses that you will find in India. And we are a very conscious university. If we've fallen short somewhere, we shall take that extra mile to cover up for our laxity. So while we were arranging for the program, we realized that the venue did not have a ramp. And very shortly you will realize that especially if it's you will come in and perform. So over the course of the last 3 to 4 days, the team worked day and day to also get a temporary ramp fixed up. But we are sure that a permanent ramp will be set up in this hall as well. Moving on, I would now like to request Honorable Mr. Justice Ujjal, who is the guest of honor for this evening. Please come in and address this office gallery. Sir?
Specially able or persons who are differently able. the nomenclature itself, I think, requires some reconsideration, more so that we look at it from the prism of a right-based approach. Persons who are differently able do not require charity. It is not charity. They are citizens of this country. And as citizens of this country, they have full right, equal rights under Article 14 and Article 21 of the Constitution. So therefore, we have to look at it from the prism of a right-based approach. And what has been said today about the mindset, we need to create awareness, the mindset. But I must say, when we look at India as a whole, our country has made tremendous progress over the years. Infrastructure, science, technology, medical science, education, it has made tremendous progress. And of course, the creation of this middle class in the last 2-3 decades is a significant development which cannot be overlooked. It has acted like a catalyst pulling up the economy. But having said that, there is also a dark underbelly in our country, and this is not confined to one particular region, it is across the board. We have to acknowledge that India is a country with deep-rooted, deep-seated prejudices. We as a people, consciously or unconsciously, harbor a lot of prejudices. And these prejudices need not be one-dimensional or unidimensional, it can be multiple prejudices and working at multiple levels. Prejudices can work. It can be caste-based, which is the reality. It can be ethnic-based, it can be religious-based, and it can also be social, there can be social prejudices, like discrimination against the girl child, prejudice against women, color-based. If you see in most families, when a child is born, two things are asked. Whether it's a boy, and secondly, whether it's the baby's fair complexion or not. These are the two things immediately, and it is not based on one community or one region, everything. So these prejudices are very much present. And if you look at our popular culture or popular entertainment, we make fun of people who are disabled or differently abled. Our theatres, our cinemas are full of episodes where we make fun of people who stammer, people who are obese, people who are squint-eyed, people who are short. So, as Vice Chancellor said, this has come over the years. It's not easy to cleanse ourselves or to extricate ourselves from this deep-seated prejudice. So, therefore, what I feel that having a center like this certainly would be a step in the right direction. It will create the requisite awareness, and who else can be the torch bearers of such a change other than the students of the National Law University? You are the persons who have to take the lead in trying to change the mindset of the people. Think and act as is required of our constitution. I'm also very happy that this center will also deal with health laws. The health laws, as we all know, is an integral part of Article 21. Access to health is a fundamental right. Right to life includes right to health, access to health. And embedded in this health laws, there are various other issues also, including the issue of gender. There's a new emerging jurisprudence, the jurisprudence of reproductive rights, whether women have a choice or whether women have a voice, whether to have a child or not to have a child, whether she has control over her biological faculties. Because she is in full control of her body and mind. These are issues, I'm sure, will be debated, discussed, researched in this center. University is a place where of free thinking, unfettered, unhindered thinking, and I'm sure without obstacles, without a big brother watching, I'm sure the students and all the faculty members, the research scholars who are associated with this center will come up with positive ideas. And therefore, at this juncture, my best wishes to Professor Sachin and all the faculty members and the students who are associated with this center, and I wish this center all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Lordship, for your insightful address. But while we say that we are going to begin a paradigm shift, it was probably a matter of coincidence that while I was working with Sachin sir on this project, that a very disheartening incident happened. And that is where I'd like to share this with you. Just a fortnight back, I had gone to the pharmacist to get a medicine for my friend who was seriously ill. And given that it's armed out, it takes quite a hassle to go to the city and get it. So I noticed that there's this elderly man at the counter who's trying to buy a prescription drug. And the simple thing that he kept on pestering the pharmacist was, what is the expiry date of that drug? The man over the counter hurled expletives on this elderly gentleman who couldn't see. It was no fault of his, and told him, मुझ पर भरोसा नहीं है, मार डालूंगा, बोल दिया मैं एक बार, जाइए आप. So I rushed to his aid and I assisted him with what the expiry date on that drug was. I mean, we have gone to the Chief Justice and the sitting judge of the High Court sitting here. I mean, it's not that you have to go to a court to get justice. The preamble of the Constitution says justice has three tenets: justice, social, economic, and political. Probably if the pharmacist that day had probably treated the man with a bit of sensitivity, he would have done justice to that particular opportunity which he would. So that is what we need to evolve in our country. Hopefully, with your blessing, sir, the center will be able to do what we set up with an objective to do. Moving on. I would now like to request Mr. Vinod Seshan to please come over and unveil our new center website and our logo. And I request Mr. Satyajit there to please assist him in the process. Center now has its own identity. Moving on, the following two events are the evening special lecture. we have children from India with special abilities who will be performing a dance performance, but a little later. But I have another little student who will come in and sing a beautiful song for us. Huge round of applause for her.
Bohu asahirotar bipurite gohir asahirotar.